1960s, many black and white Americans joined in nonviolent protest of the widespread discrimination throughout the country. Sit-ins at northern lunch counters and marches through the South.
The civil rights movement had inspired a new generation of community advocates. In Tucson, one of the most active areas for social change was developing on the south and west side. The most pressing need was for accessible and affordable health care for more than 10,000 residents who are living near or below the poverty level. Now, at the very same time, but from a different direction, the founding dean of the University of Arizona's College of Medicine, Dr. Merlin Duvall, was looking for a better way to train doctors by giving them real-world, one-on-one experience with patients.
By bringing the physicians, even as undergraduate students, medical students, and then as residents, into the actual community, they get a feel for medicine and the role that medicine plays, let alone the satisfaction of doing the best they can on behalf of people who need their help.
In addition, Dr. Duvall, too, was concerned that a desperate health care need was going unmet in our community. Then a huge federal funding door opened.
This administration today, here and now, declares unconditional war on poverty in America.
The Johnson administration's War on Poverty campaign made millions of dollars available to launch a new concept in public health, neighborhood health centers. And the stars, says Dr. Duvall, aligned.
The stars were in alignment, no question about that. I think at another moment, we would not have been so fortunate.
Two powerful forces, the University of Arizona and those newly empowered community advocates, were about to collide, reconcile, then join in a partnership. A partnership that over the years would bring life-saving health care to hundreds of thousands of men, women, and children in our community. The story of El Rio Community Health Center is better told through the eyes of some of those who were there at the very beginning. Jaime Gutierrez was just barely 21, and back then very much a novice when it came to community organizing. But Ramon Jariqui was a seasoned neighborhood activist. His daughter remembers.
He was always at meetings, trying to get something done, working hard, working late.
Working hard, working late. It became the mantra of not just the neighborhood activists, but also that of Dr. Duvall. He recognized, though, that if a community health center was going to happen, he needed help. Enter Dr. Herb Abrams. Dr. Abrams had launched such a center in Chicago and had a way of gaining the trust of community leaders. And trust would be hard to come by. You see, all this came in the wake of the controversy surrounding the building of the Tucson Convention Center and a community dispute over building parts of I-10.
Hundreds of homes had been razed and people had been forced to move elsewhere. And they were, many people were quite angry about that. And here I come along representing the university, this colossus in the community, and proposing something new, and one would think, well, gee, a health center, anybody would welcome it, but people wanted to know the details of this before accepting it. So I had to overcome a certain amount of skepticism.
But it wasn't just the community's skepticism that Dr. Abrams had to overcome. There was also a real power struggle going on among 12 separate neighborhood groups.
I'll tell you, it was rogues gallery with a lot of those incorporators. I mean, these were folks who were beating up on the city, you know, who were demanding that they get housing services, healthcare services, educational services. I mean, these were folks that, like I said, had been veterans, had been activists, were still there pounding on the doors and were still there demanding those very basic things that I think as residents we take for granted now.
ustedes se tenieron que unirse, ¿verdad? Sí. ¿Y cómo hicieron eso?
By fighting.
You heard him right. Ramon said, by fighting. But very quickly, the neighborhood leaders learned it was better to fight for something together than spend any time turning on one another. Unity became the goal.
Even the arguments on the board were a symptom of their support. I mean, the people on the board took this thing seriously, and that's why they had arguments. And so that's my view of arguments. Arguments are healthy. You got to have them to work things out.
Because we wanted to get the things done, and that's why we were fighting for getting the things done.
And get it done they did. The university applied for the grant, and with the help of the neighborhood organizers, the vision soon became reality. Pima County helped out too. The county donated the building, the abandoned Mother Higgins Juvenile Detention Center, plus $50,000 to help with renovations.
The story I most like to tell is that there were 18 jail cells in that building. And those 18 jail cells were all around about 8 by 9 feet in dimension. They were perfect for doctors' examining rooms.
And watching it all, right there from the very beginning, was Jessie Reese. She was the assistant to El Rio's very first executive director. She has been at El Rio the longest of any employee. 35 years later, she has her own message to deliver.
El Rio is unique, and I'm surprised that some people still don't know about El Rio, or they have a misconception that it's just for people in the lower income bracket. We're for everyone who wants to use our services. It's top notch.
Jesse says that while El Rio may have once been viewed by some as the healthcare of last resort, today it is the healthcare of choice for many people all over Tucson. Today, El Rio is the 14th largest community health center in the nation, with an annual budget of more than $45 million. The center employs 512 professionals. The El Rio Community Health Center serves almost 70,000 disadvantaged Tucsonans per year in all of these areas. And every day, people continue to come to El Rio, not only because of, as Jesse calls it, top-notch service, but also because of the respect the staff shows towards every client, regardless of the ability to pay. Leticia Palomino knows about that firsthand. She has three sons who all suffer from acute asthma.
Well, like I said, it's like trying to breathe on the water. You can't.
It's so scary and it feels like you're going to die.
We entered into the El Rio program. They taught me what preventions I can take. With their help, our landlord installed the AC unit. We pulled out the carpet and tile was added. I feel that they treated us tremendously.
From taking care of the Palomino boys who are just starting their lives to taking care of patients like Catalina Huerta, who came to the end of her life in her 90s under El Rio's medical care, certain things remain constant. Quality care that is administered with respect while safeguarding the dignity of each patient.
She didn't have a lot of money, and I don't have a lot of money, but she said one time we were chatting, she says, if there's any funds left over after I pass away, give them to El Rio. And sure enough, there was enough to give El Rio $5,000. And that touched me.
El Rio just didn't evolve last week. I mean, it was an evolution of 35 years. And I know many times El Rio has had its ups and downs, but the fact is that in 2005, El Rio, I think, is the premier healthcare provider for folks on the west and south side of Tucson.
I had the feeling all the time that the El Rio would go on, that we'd never go out of existence, because it just needed too much. And we had the support of the community.
when we put competent people in place and they do a good job and you meet a community need, that in itself is, in my judgment, a very adequate definition of success.
When you look at the list of incorporators, there were some dynamite community leaders. There were folks who had been there in the trenches for 20, 30 years, folks who had sometimes been beaten down, folks who sometimes hadn't won all the battles, and yet they had, and they continued to have that vision, and they continued to have that drive because healthcare was so important for all of us.
Standing the test of time, El Rio Community Health Center has done that. It lives on as a legacy to those who stood up when the time came to be counted. They are the originals, the foundation on which this community treasure will continue to grow and serve the people of Tucson.
Is there still a lot to fight for?
Oh, yes, there's still a lot.
Are you still willing to fight?
Oh, yes, you better believe it.